All right, YouTube, I get to drive Stu's car. I've actually never driven a 360, so this will be my first time driving it, and it should be fun. We gotta take it and drop it off to get the top fixed, so he's having a bunch of work done. All right, let's drive the 360. There we go. All right.
Feels similar.
Jerkier. Totally different feeling. Listen to this. It's so loud. Starts to liven up above 4,000. All right, so it's actually got a good pop when you let out the gas. Yeah, now we're getting somewhere. The upper RPMs is really where this thing sings. The transmission is definitely a lot slower, so when I hit downshift, watch. Lot, sorry, but get that little, not with the exhaust, you get that little pop that mine has, that really loud, nice sound. Here we go, let's try this. All right, so that was really interesting. When I upshifted with my foot down, I smacked the rev limiter. So I don't think it behaves the same as mine, where you can just keep your foot planted. I think you actually need to let up on the gas as you shift up under hard acceleration. But under low acceleration, it seemed, you know, if you're only down a halfway, it doesn't matter. But this was like foot to the floor kind of acceleration. Other than that, the downshifts are about the same. Also, it beeped at me earlier when I was just sitting for about 1 minute with it in gear. So I think it complains when it's stuck in gear. My car, I think, gives you like 4 minutes before it complains. So just weird little differences. It definitely is a slower transmission, but it's got the same kind of basic feel, although a little bit softer, squishier, if that makes sense. All right, let it rip.
Yeah.